Good morning, everybody. Good to see you this morning. Happy Father's Day to all the fathers here today. We're glad that you're here in the house of the Lord. And we're just looking forward to a great day here this morning. So get ready and let's believe the Lord to do great things. We'd like to make a few announcements, though, before we get into the service. And they'll be on your screen and I'll read them to you this morning. We're real excited. The Wednesday night Bible study, Jesus is coming, the rapture. And if you haven't been to the Wednesday night Bible study, I believe you'll be blessed by this study. So come on out and be with us. Also, we need volunteers for Vacation Bible School sign-up. There's a sign-up sheet in the foyer. If you would sign up and help us, we need volunteers to help with Bible school. And that's out on the foyer. It's a sign-up sheet. And I'd like to encourage you all, if you can, to help us out with this. We kicked it off last night. It went real well. And we've got three more events coming up. We're going to take it on the street. We're going to go to Arrowhead Beach. We're going to go to Mission Mill Park in Hertford. And we're going downtown at the John A. Holmes High School for Vacation Bible School. So please keep that in mind. This is coming soon, too, on July the 3rd at 5 o'clock. We're going to have a 4th of July celebration that day. I want you to come out and be with us. We're going to have all kinds of things for the kids. And I feel like you'll be blessed. Hamburgers and hot dogs for adults. And we might even make you some homemade ice cream if you show up. Amen? So come on and be with us July the 3rd at 5 o'clock. Also, the Man Up service or men's meeting is coming up on July the 6th, 2021 at 7. You don't want to miss that, men. Be a part of that. If you haven't been coming, I'd like to encourage you to come to the men's group. You will really be blessed. We're having some great times together at the men's group. We have supper, and we have a great time planned for you for fellowship. Also, the Rise Up Women's Meeting is coming soon, and I want you to be a part of that on July the 13th, 2021 at 6:30. The guest speaker will be Darlene McCallum, and she's going to be speaking for us. She also sings, and you'll be blessed by her ministry. You really don't want to miss this, ladies, and make sure that you make that part of your sign-up. So I think that's most of the announcements. Is that all of them, Kurt? We got one more this morning I believe we're going to do. And I'd like to say some congratulations to some people here this morning. I would like to congratulate Rose and Jonathan. They both became black belts in karate this week. Oh, yes. Don't mess. I encourage you, don't mess with them too. Amen. But we are proud of them. We got one more that we would like to honor this morning. And if we put that up on the screen this morning, we're proud. We're very proud. I'm really proud. Amen. Of this young man. Yes, we're really proud of Jalen. He's my grandson. I've got the big head right now. But anyway, Jalen did real well this past week at the Eastern Regionals in track. He finished first place in the long jump and first place in the triple jump. And because of that, next Friday, he will be going to state finals in Greensboro. Amen. Proud of him this morning, and he's a top. So I know he really wants to do this, but Jalen, stand up and let him see who Jalen is this morning. All right. That's Jalen right there. All right. And turn to your neighbor and say, we're proud of all of our kids. All of our kids this morning. Praise the Lord. Amen. All right, Amy, where are you at?
Jesus loves me. At this time, we're going to start by having our Father's Day recognition this morning to recognize all the fathers that are here today.
Okay. What is a dad? A dad is a person who is loving and kind, and often he knows what you have on your mind. He's someone who listens, suggests, and defends. A dad can be one of your very best friends. He's proud of your triumphs, but when things go wrong, a dad can be patient and helpful and strong. In all that you do, a dad's love plays a part. There's always a place for him deep in your heart. In each year that passes, you're even more glad, more grateful and proud just to call him your dad. Thank you, Dad, for listening and caring, for giving and sharing, but especially for just being you. And Pastor Danny, we've got something a little special for you if you want to come on up here. We've got, we just want to thank you for you being you and being the father to this church and being a father to all of us. And we've got a little poem for you, just special for you.
Thanks.
God took the strength of a mountain, the majesty of a tree, the warmth of a summer sun, the calm of a quiet sea, the generous soul of nature, the comforting arm of night, the wisdom of the ages, the power of the eagle's flight, the joy of a morning and spring, the faith of a mustard seed, the patience of eternity, the depth of a family need. Then God combined these qualities when there was nothing more to add. He knew his masterpiece was complete, and so he called it Dad.
Thank you so very much. I mean, am I on? Amen. It is my privilege and my opportunity and my great honor to serve this church, and I'm so thankful for every one of you here this morning. Thank you for this gift this morning, but most of all, thank you for letting me be your pastor. God bless you. I love every one of you. Amen. Thank you so much. Amen.
Now let's all stand and worship this morning.
I saw the Lord seated on the throne. He was clothed in glory, exalted high, and the train of his robe, it filled the temple, and the angels gathered round him.
You are holy, most of all.
we just honor you and praise you and lift up your name, Lord. You are worthy of all praise. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Let the worshipers arise. Let the sons and daughters sing.
I surrender.
I want to say something to you this morning. How many of you believe that the God we serve is worthy of our worship? Do you believe that this morning? Well, I want to encourage you this morning, and I don't know who this is for, but you may come in here feeling like that you're not fit to worship, but it's not whether you're fit to worship or not. That's a fact that he's worthy of worship. It's not your fitness, it's the fact that he's worthy of worship. And you may have come in here broken this morning, but being broken does not disqualify you from being blessed. Because when you begin to bless the Lord, he begins to heal the broken. When you begin to worship the Lord, angels begin to feel the atmosphere. When you begin to worship the Lord, the Holy Spirit begins to move and manifest in the midst of his people. That's why your Bible says, enter into his courts with thanksgiving and into his presence with praise. That's why your Bible said that when we come here, we ought to exalt the name of the Lord and the house of God forever. Let the worshipers arise. And Jesus said, in the last days, saith God, I seek such to worship me in spirit and in truth. God is looking for some worshipers this morning. And he's looking for the broken. And just because you're broken does not disqualify you from being blessed.
I raise a hallelujah in the presence of my I raise a hallelujah louder than the unbelief. I raise a hallelujah. My weapon is a melody. I raise a hallelujah. Heaven comes. Louder. In the presence of the enemies, sing a little.
Turn your neighbor, say neighbor. Neighbor. I don't think we're done with that one.
Neighbor.
Tell them I need a little bit more. Tell them I need a whole lot more.
Amen.
Tell them you can have all you want this morning. Amen. How many of you are thankful for the mercy of God this morning?
Amen.
If you're here by the mercy of God, wave at me this morning. I'm here by the mercy of God this morning. If the Lord wasn't on my side, I don't know where I would be at this morning, but I'm here this morning, and I'm glad to be here. I want you to do one more thing. Turn your neighbor, say, neighbor.
Neighbor.
Say, God's not through.
God's not through.
And it's not through with you.
Not through
with you. Oh, you should have said that with conviction. Say, God's not through.
God's not through.
And it's not through with you. And you, and you. And it's not through with that song either. We're going to sing a little bit more. Amen. Give me a little bit more of that, Amy.
God of mercy, sweet love of mine.
You can be seated if you want to. That's up to you. It's not mandatory. I mean, you can stand if you want to. Amen. Praise God. Praise God. Praise God. Hallelujah. Praise God. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Praise God. Praise God. Has the Lord been good to anybody here this morning? Amen. Been good to anybody. He's been good to me this morning. I am grateful this morning for the blessings and the benefits of the Lord Jesus Christ. I want you this morning this is a rhema word for some in this room this morning, maybe for not all, but I really believe a rhema word is a specific word spoken at a specific time for a specific need or person this morning. So I believe this morning, how many of you are tired of just beating around the bush? You just want to go all the way in this thing this morning. How many of you know the only way to serve God is all the way, not halfway, not straddle the fence, but make your mind up this morning, I'm going to serve the Lord. I'm going to cast my anchor in the rock of ages. I've made my mind up to serve Him, and nothing shall stop me from serving God. He that's got an ear this morning, hear me. It's time to sell out and serve the Lord, because Jesus Christ is soon coming. I've come to tell you, it's time to launch this morning. Turn to your neighbor and say, you need to take off this morning. Tell him you need to turn the volume up this morning. How many remember when you were younger riding down the road and your favorite song would come on the radio? So you reach over there and say, turn it up. Does anybody know what I'm talking about this morning? I think it's time for the church and Christians this morning to turn the volume up this morning. If the world can hoot and holler and shout about a stock car race or a ball game, we can holler, hoop, and shout about a Savior that loved us, died for us, and coming back again. I'm telling you, it's time to launch this morning. It's time to make your mind up this morning that I'm going to serve the true and living God, and there is none other this morning. I feel the Holy Ghost in this room this morning. God is doing so. And it's time for the church to take off. Anybody else believe that this morning? I believe the church has sat silent for too long. I believe we've sat back and let the enemy just do what he wanted to. But I come to tell you right now, there is a rhema word for some people in this room this morning. There are some hungry folks in here. There's some people that don't care what folks think about them. They don't care how they look at them. They don't care. Listen, there's some folks don't even care. If you call me a holy roller, let me have it. Hallelujah. Can I get a witness this morning? I've been called one all my life. And I don't consider it as criticism. I consider it as a compliment. Now, I know that we just sat down, but I want you to stand up. I'm going to give you a short message this morning, but it's got a lot to say in it this morning. Stand up just with me this morning. If we stood up to sing, we can stand up for the word, can we not? Luke chapter 5, verse 1 through 4. Ooh, I feel the Holy Ghost in this room. Don't you feel the Holy Ghost in this room, Sarah? Oh, hallelujah. I can just look at the word and read the word, and it causes a shout. It causes a hallelujah to rise up in me this morning. And it came to pass that as the people pressed upon him to hear the word of God, he stood by the lake of Gennesaret and saw two ships standing by the lake. But the fishermen were gone out of them and were washing their nets. And he entered into one of the ships, which was Simon's, and prayed him that he would thrust out a little from land. And he said, and he sat down and taught the people out of the ship. Now when he had left speaking, he said unto Simon, launch out into the deep and let down your nets for a draw. If I don't say nothing else, that's good right by itself this morning. There was one word that Jesus said there that leaped off the page and lodged into my spirit this week, and that one word was launch. How many of you know that word means to take off? It means to catapult. It means to thrust forward. It means that you're no longer going to sit on the sidelines and be a spectator, but you're going to get with it and get on with it and let this world know that there's a Savior and His name is Jesus this morning. It's time for you and I to launch this morning. Let us pray. Father, I come to you in the name of Jesus. Hide me behind the cross. Let me break the bread under the inspiration of the Holy Spirit. Lord, I pray your word to go forth in demonstration and power. And Lord, all this done, we'll praise you and give you glory, for we ask it all in Jesus' name. Amen and amen. You may be seated in the house of the Lord this morning. I want you to understand that your Bible says in the book of Hebrews that at sundry times in diverse manners in the last days we've been spoken to by the prophets, but hath in these last days been spoken to by Jesus Christ. He that's got an ear, let him hear what the Spirit is saying to the church and every individual Christian under the sound of my voice. The word of the Lord came unto me saying, I want you to tell my people that it's time for us to launch. It's time we understand this morning that it's not enough to come to church. It's time to be the church. Can I get a witness? It's not enough just to sing. It's a time to serve. It's a time to live for God. It's a time to say to this world goodbye and make your mind up that I'm going to go where Jesus wants me to go. I'm going to do what He wants me to do. I'm going to live the way He wants me to live. I'm coming all the way with Jesus this morning. I want you to get this in your spirit. When I got ready to come to church this week, and especially last night and this morning, this thing kept rolling over in my mind. I didn't understand what the Lord was saying to me all week long, Beth, until last night late. This past Monday, He put a word in me that said, shake it off. Turn to your neighbor and say, shake it off. Have you ever seen a baseball player get hit by the ball or twist his ankle? And have you ever seen a runner like Jeff? Like Jalen, I don't know about Jeff anymore, but like Jalen, can I get a witness? You ever seen one, you know, where he got hit or twisted his ankle and the coach would holler out, walk it off! And he would hurt a little bit, then all of a sudden he just got going again. Some of us need to understand that it's time we walk it off. It don't care if it don't matter if nobody else has served the Lord. You got to make your mind up that you're going to serve the Lord. It doesn't matter if nobody else comes to church. You got to make your mind up you're coming to church. Matter of fact, it don't make no matter what anybody says about you. Let them say what they will. But one of these days, those that are launching now are about to launch again and be in the presence of God forever and forever. And the word of the Lord came unto me, shake it off this morning. Whatever's tried to attach itself to you, get rid of it this morning. If there's any ill feelings, get rid of it this morning. If there's any envy or jealousy or strife, get rid of it this morning. If you got any baggage, get rid of it this morning. Lay it all down this morning. It don't matter, ladies and gentlemen. You got to get up, get on with it, and serve God yourself. You're going to answer for yourself at the end of this journey, not someone else. And that is what God is saying to me this week. He said, you got to get to the place you understand. You got to shake some things off. You got to shake what people say about you. Can I get a witness this morning? How many of you live long enough to know that everybody don't love you? How many of you live long enough to know everybody ain't crazy about you this morning? We like to think that everybody loves us, but I got news for you. Everybody don't love you, but the one that does love you matters. Can I get a witness this morning? Boy, I'd have shouted if I'd have been you right then. That was an amen line if I've ever heard one. God is saying to you and I this morning, like He said to His disciples in Luke chapter 5. I want to set the stage for you. They had been out fishing all night long. And the Bible says in another text explaining this, they toiled all night and they caught nothing. Here's another word the Lord put in my spirit. He said, I want you to tell them not only to shake it off, I want you to tell them, just do it. Turn to your neighbor and say, just do it. Some of y'all been thinking about shouting. Can I get a witness this morning? Some of you have been thinking about raising your hand, and you got it just about here. That's called half mass. Can I get a witness? Y'all know when we do the flag half mass what it means, don't you? And some would dibble a dabble just a little bit, and I'm going to give God just. But God is saying to you and I, like he said to blind Bartimaeus, and like blind Bartimaeus said to him, I once was blind, but now I see. And I'll tell you, I don't know much about him, but this one thing I do know, he gave me sight, he gave me light, and I will worship him, I will serve him, and I'll just do it this morning. You got to get to the place you're not ashamed to give God praise. You're not ashamed to worship the Lord. Somebody said, well, everybody worships the Lord different. I know that. I'm glad we are different, aren't you? Aren't you glad that everybody's not like you? Wouldn't this be a messed up world if we were all just alike? But my point to you is, what Jesus is looking for is a people that will just go all the way with him and do whatever he says to. In that same text in Luke chapter 5, when they fished and toiled all night long, they hadn't caught a thing, but Simon Peter had the best answer that he could have given Jesus. He said, Lord, we have fished and toiled all night and caught nothing. Nevertheless, everybody say, nevertheless, at thy word, we will cast out our nets for a draw. How many about ready to get a draw of the Holy Ghost this morning? How many about ready to get filled this morning? How many know there's more to this thing than sitting on church pews this morning? I'll tell you, there's depths we've never been. There's heights I've never climbed. There's experiences I've never had before. And God is saying to you, come and dine. The table is spread on Father's Day. The Lord said, I'm going to start. I'm going to ignite a revival. And there's going to be some folks that's going to say, enough is enough. I'm going to launch out this morning. And that word means that you're gonna. One definition translated in the Greek, which that's where the New Testament was written in. It says that word that Jesus spoke to him was a word that says, "I just want you to thrust out. I want you to push everything out of the way." How many about ready to do that this morning? What he was saying was, "I know you're tired. I know you're weary." I know COVID has wearied and tired a lot of us. Can I get a witness this morning? I know that 2020 was a tough, rough year. But I want you to know this morning that I believe it's over and it's time for the church to rise and shine and say, I'm going to launch with Jesus. I'm going to go where he wants me to go. I'm going to do what he wants me to do. Did you know sometimes you got to leave where you are to get to where God wants to use you? Boy, I'd have preached real hard then if I... Let me come back and talk to y'all. Y'all shout more back when this happens. Sometimes you just got to leave the crowd. Come on, can I get a witness? And sometimes when you leave the crowd, they're going to think you nuts. Can I get a witness? They thought Bartimaeus was crazy when he cried out to Jesus. And they thought these fishermen in Luke chapter 5 had lost their minds. They had already fished all night. Jesus said, let me borrow your boat. And go out a little bit from the shore. How many of you know that sometimes you got to get deeper in Christ? You just can't wait around the shoreline all the time. Now, here's a real good one. Y'all probably ain't going to shout on me on this, but I'm going to tell you right now, some of us need to grow up. Can I get a witness this morning? Come on now. I knew I was doing good, but the Lord told me 3 times, go on and say it, so I said it. Can I get a witness? Some of you, some of me, some of us, myself, we need to learn how to take a licking and keep on ticking. We need to roll and rumble and keep right on going. We need to understand this morning, though no one joined me, I think I'll launch out with Jesus this morning. I think I'll go on an adventure with him this morning. How many know it's better to be in the boat with Jesus than to be in the boat without Jesus? How many of you know this world can get tough? Jesus was saying this to this group, Simon, I want you to let me get in the boat, and I want you to let down your nets. Turn your neighbor said, every now and then, you got to let go and let God. How many of you know you can't catch the fish? How many know you can't fix everybody? I found that out a long time ago. I found out a long time ago that you cannot fix everybody, but there's one that can, and his name is Jesus. I want to ask you, is Jesus working on anybody in this house? Is anybody on the potter's wheel this morning? Is anybody ready to go deeper? Is anybody ready to go to experiences you've ever had with God? Does anybody understand this morning that it's more than a shallow walk with God? It's getting into the deep things of God. It's digging deep with God. It's getting down. It's getting down where you just get more of God than you've ever wanted in your life. I've been serving God since December of 1975, but I'm here to tell you right now, I am more hungry for God this morning than I've ever been in my life. Is anybody else hungry for God this morning? It's a heart panteth after the water brook, so doth my soul panteth after thee. Lead me to a rock that is higher than I. Great is the Lord. Hallelujah. I'm looking for a great, deep experience with God. So when the enemy comes in like a flood, the Spirit will raise a standard against me. I'll weeble and I'll wobble, but I won't get down. Can I get a witness this morning? And I'm going to help somebody. If you do get down, get up. Tell three people to get up this morning. You got three folks on your row. Lean over there and tell them to get up this morning. Jesus would say, get up. They would, you know what they were doing, Terry? They were doing like some of us. I couldn't find me a net this morning. I wanted to find me a fishing net. But they were sitting there washing their nets. Well, it was a bad day. Caught nothing. Just sitting there. By the Lake Center, if you could get this in your mind, they were sitting there washing their nets. Well, it didn't happen. Not today. Enough fish today. And no doubt they were discouraged, and they were probably a little down. And they said, we've done everything we've always done, but we just didn't catch no fish. And they were sitting there washing those nets where their heads hung over, their spirits were low. They felt like they had nothing, they caught nothing, they couldn't do anything. And then somebody said, and then Jesus, say that with, and then Jesus came on the scene. I'm going to stop camp out there a while. How many of you are glad that Jesus comes on the scene just in time this morning? About the time they were getting ready to take, I don't know if they had pocket knives back then, but I believe some of them were so disgusted, they were going to rip their nets apart, tear it all up, and say, I'm done. But I come to tell somebody, don't you do that this morning. God's not done with you yet. He's just getting started. He's wanting you to launch out in the deep this morning. That is what God is saying. God is saying that I know you're discouraged. I know you're down. Now, I don't know if I'm talking to everybody, but I'm talking to some in this room today. You felt like taking your nets and ripping them apart. You felt like taking your towel and throwing it in. You felt like saying enough is enough. I'm tired of fishing. Ain't nothing happening. Let me tell you something right now. I'm telling you, I have been fishing for souls for 40 years, and I intend to fish for souls until I die. Can I get a witness in this house this morning? Sometimes you catch them, and sometimes you don't. And I am telling you, how many of you love to go fishing when you catch a lot? How many of you like Cynthia? 5 minutes, you ain't caught nothing. Let's go to the house. Y'all with me this morning? 5 minutes. We went fishing last week. 5 minutes. I mean, I hadn't even got my cork on my pole yet. Cynthia said, come on, I'm ready to go. There ain't no fish in here. And we didn't catch nothing last week. I'm going somewhere. Tell your neighbor, say, he's going somewhere. Didn't catch a thing last week. Well, this past Thursday, we went right back to the same spot, stood in the same place, and I'm telling you, before Cynthia could get her
cork in the water, I was already pulling a fish out of it. And she looked at me, Donnie, she said, "Woo, they're biting the day." Can I get a witness in here? Everybody likes it when they're biting. Oh, Stan, it was a great day. Oh, I had my 5-gallon bucket. I had it full of brim. I was throwing catfish in, back, and left. I was having the time of my life. But I'm telling you, I don't always catch fish like that. But when I do, I'm a shout. And when I don't, I'm a shout. I'm going to go with Jesus. I'm not looking fish out of the meal pot. I'm looking souls for Jesus. That's what I'm looking for this morning. And we'll win some and we'll lose some. I've seen it in the church. I've seen them come, seen them go. And I loved them coming, and I loved them going. But it ain't never going to stop me from fishing for souls. The measure of a church is not how many you keep. It's how many you send to win souls. You let that sink into your spirit this morning. They were fishermen. They wanted to catch fish, but they didn't. Jesus was using an analogy from catching fish to catching souls, to reaching people, to trying to get people saved. How many of you want this to be a soul-saving station out here? I want us to become the lovingest church in Chowan County. I want somebody to say, if they don't say nothing about them folks down there, I'll tell you one thing, that's the lovingest crowd I've ever seen in my life. Turn your neighbor and say, I love you this morning. I love you this morning. Oh, if your family's here, tell them you love them this morning. How many of you know you can't argue with somebody that's loving on you? You can't do that. How many of you know love covers a multitude of faults? Jesus loved those fishermen, and he loved them when they were discouraged, and he loves you when you're discouraged. He loved them when they were catching nothing, and he loved them when they were filling the boat. Listen what Jesus said. Cast, you go home and read it when you go home today. Read the rest of the story like Paul Harvey would say. They cast a net on the other side of the boat. And when they did, they caught so many fish that the nets broke. How many of you want a net-breaking blessing this morning? How many of you want to get so full you'll bubble over this morning? When is the last time you got so happy you couldn't hardly stand it this morning? Somebody needs to get happy in the house of God again. I'm telling you, if the church ain't happy, nobody's coming. Can I get a witness this morning? I'm tired of dead, plucked up. Listen, I wouldn't give you 5 cents for formal religion. I want the fire of God. Anybody else? I wouldn't give you 5 cents for going through a program. I want the power of the Holy Ghost. I wouldn't give you the time of day for just going through a ceremony. I want to see him high and lifted up and his train fill the temple. That's what I want to see. I want to launch out with Jesus and be with him. See, we need Jesus to help us fish. We need Jesus to help us live right. See, that's the reason some people don't come and serve God and don't come to church, because they see people, religious folks, but they ain't seen some folks that's in love with Jesus. We got to get people in love with Jesus again. So what Jesus said to me this week, he said, I want you to launch. I did some good Sunday writing. Here's what he said. Y'all might not get this language, but this is what it means in the Greek. He said, I'm looking for some folks. That word launch means, are you ready for it? To throw down. How many of you know what I'm talking about, throwing down? I'm going to get all up where you live. Now, how many of you been known to throw down every now and then? How many of you used to throw down? Oh, y'all act like y'all ain't never lived in the world. I've come to tell, listen, this ain't my first rodeo. I've been there and done that. You think I've been saved all my life? I have not. I have thrown down for the world, and now I'm throwing down for Jesus, and I'm going to launch out in the deep this morning. That's why the word launch means to throw down. I heard the young folks say, we're going to throw down tonight. I'll tell you what. You throw down with me, you'll throw that other stuff in the trash. Can I get a witness? Oh, yeah, I'm drinking right now, but I ain't drinking what you think I'm drinking. Oh, you take a hit what I'm hitting. Oh, it's good. Can I get a witness this morning? Oh, does anybody know what I'm talking about? The kingdom of heaven is not meat and it's not drink. It's joy in the Holy Ghost. Somebody needs to get happy in the Holy Ghost again. Somebody said, well, I don't know about that in that church. I mean, that's a place you ought to be quiet. Yes, it is. It's a place you ought to reverence. Yes, it is. But it's also a place you ought to be thankful. It's also a place you ought to worship. It's also a place you ought to just throw down every now and then and give Jesus a good praise. Now, I had to write this down because it was coming. So you note takers, turn your neighbor and say, we're just about home right now. But I don't stay up like I do to give in here, come for 5 minutes. How many of you don't need more than that? You need a meal this morning. How many of you need Jesus? Does anybody need Jesus? Here's what it said. That word means to throw down. It means to release. Sometimes you've got to let go of some things. Sometimes you have to let go of some people. Can I get a witness? Sometimes you got to let go of the crowd. And sometimes you just got to live for God yourself. That's the only way to live. Here's the three things right quick. Well, Jesus said, when you launch out in the deep and you let down your net, you'll be filled with joy unspeakable. I didn't finish my fish story a while ago. When we got through fishing, we were out there, won't nobody at the meal pot. Usually it's four or five people out there, nobody but us. If y'all had seen us out there, you'd have thought Cynthia and Danny has lost their mind. Oh, we were sitting there. We were almost to the point of high-fiving one another. Yeah, I got another one. Oh, my fish was bigger than yours. I'd be all down in the 5 gallon bucket. No, it's not. I caught this one right here. We had joy. We were excited, and I'm telling you right now, that may be a little bit strange of an analogy, but yet it's not, because Jesus used it. Jesus said about fishing, let it down, you're going to catch a lot of fish. I'm telling you right now, if you would just understand this morning, if you would let God, He would give you joy unspeakable this morning. How many have been happy in the Holy Ghost? Anybody? How many have ever laughed in the Spirit? Anybody? Have y'all ever been to places before where you wasn't supposed to laugh and something funny happened? You give it that number. Does anybody know what I'm talking about? You couldn't hold it in. And you couldn't look at the one sitting beside you because they were doing the same thing. And they just had so much laughter in that. How many know laughter is good? It's good medicine. Jesus said, if you do what I tell you to do, launch on out with me, get with me, live for me, serve me, walk with me, talk with me, fellowship with me. If you do that, I'll give you joy unspeakable. And the net can be not a natural net, but I'll give you joy unspeakable in your heart. That's where joy is. It's not around you. It's in you. Joy is not something that is external. It's internal. And God is saying, if you let down your net, I'll give you unspeakable joy. Then, He says, if you let down your net, you've got more power than you thought you did. How many of you know you can do more than you thought you could do? How many understand this morning that the power of the Spirit in you helps you to do more than you could ever do by yourself? See, we can't win this community in the natural. We need the supernatural. We can't win this world through programs. We win it through the power of the Holy Spirit. And we will never catch souls unless we have compassion and love for souls. For he that wins souls is, say it with me, wise. Jesus came into this world for one reason, to seek and to save them that were lost. How many folks were lost in here? Every one of us. Every one of us was born in sin and shaping in iniquity. And our righteousness was nothing more than filthy rags in the sight of God. But Jesus came and says, if you'll let me, I'll give you joy unspeakable. If you let me, I'll put a power within you that's greater than any power you've ever experienced before. I'll put something in you that'll help you stand when you ain't catching fish. That'll help you stand when life ain't going good. And I hate to tell you this, but everything ain't going to go good. Can I get a witness? Everything is not tiptoe through the tulips. Everything is not coming up roses. But by the grace of God, I'll get through everything that comes my way. He says, if you let down your net, I will give you joy unspeakable. And I will put a power within you that's greater than anything you've ever experienced. And the last thing, Jesus said, I know you're weak, you're tired, you fished all night. Here's what he said. When you launch out into the deep, you will find strength for the journey. How many got to face some things you need some strength to face it? Are you getting it this morning? How many of you know that you will face some things that you're going to need the strength of God to get through it? I'm telling you today that the Lord dropped that one word into my spirit, launch. He said, throw down, release, catapult, take off, and serve me. I'm telling you right now, God is about to put this church to the next level. Are y'all ready to go to the next level? Are y'all ready to see God do things like we've never seen him do before? How many of you is willing to say, come on, sit on the pew with me? How many do this? My pew's full, I'll just stand up. Amen. Wouldn't that be wonderful? How many believe it's about to happen? Lord, I expect a better response than that. I'm going to try that one more time. Lord, have mercy. How many of you believe that God is about to jumpstart this church? How many of you know that when your battery's dead, if you hook it up to a hot battery, it'll cause yours to come back alive again? I'm telling you what's about to happen. God's about to plug us in. God's about to turn the volume up, and we're about to see the glory of the Lord happen, because there's some people that are tired of sitting on pews. Young people don't want religion. They want a program. They want Jesus. Your children want Jesus. And Jesus got one word for you. Launch. Come to me. Stand with me this morning, everybody. Stand with me. Hallelujah. Praise God. Thank you, Lord. Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. Woo! God is good, and he's good to you and me. When I got up, you know, I'm getting at the age now. How many know the older you get, every day is wonderful? Young folks, hear me. To you, it's just another day in the neighborhood. To us, thank God, it's another day. And the older I get, and the more I fall in love with Jesus. See, he's my Savior, but you know, he's my friend. I've been talking to him this week. Has anybody heard that song, Been Talking to Jesus? Anybody heard? If you have, I won't see your hand. Well, if you haven't, look it up on Elevation Worship. Young people, start talking to Jesus. He's always open. He's always listening. And he's here today. He's here today to bless you. If you're in this room today, and here's the last thing that I wrote down last night about 10:30, here's the very last thing I wrote down in my little notebook last night. And I want to ask you this. Look at me, everybody. I want to ask you this. And I want you to ask yourself this. What is holding you back from coming to Jesus? What is it? What is it that is holding you back? Do you think you can't live for Him? Yes, you can. Do you think you can't make it? Yes, you can. Do you think you might fall? You probably will. But He'll get you back up again. What's holding you back? What's holding you back from coming to this altar today and asking Jesus to come into your heart? I believe there's some young people in this room today that's going to come to Jesus. And they're going to take a bold step and come to them. What's holding you back? Is your peers holding you back? Is your friends holding you back? Do you think if you come to Jesus, your friends will leave? If they're your friends, they won't leave. They'll stay. And if they weren't your friends, they probably will leave. But I'm here to tell you, Jesus has said, I'm tired. I want you to launch. I want you to step out with me, out into the deep. What's holding you back? What's suppressing you today? What is it? Is it fear of faces? Is it fear that somebody will see you come to an altar? What is it? If you're here today and you want to make a public confession of Jesus Christ, that He's the Son of God, He died for you, He was raised from the dead the third day, He's coming back again, and you want to dedicate your life to Him, I'm going to ask you to be brave enough, honest enough, and obedient enough to just take about a few steps to this altar and say, I'm not ashamed to come to Jesus. Right now. Come on. Right now. Who are you? What's holding you back? What is holding you back? I'm going to tell you what's holding a lot of people back. It's one word. It's called pride. And we're too prideful to say, I need Jesus. But how many know if you get low enough, you come to Jesus? How many of you know sometimes it takes you to get low as you can go to uplift your head up to Jesus? I'm going to ask you one more time. What's holding you back? Come to Jesus. Anybody in this room? Anybody in this building want to come to Jesus? Anybody? I'm going to ask some more questions. What's holding your praise back? Is it because you don't feel worthy to praise? Is it because you feel like people will look at you? How many of you know it ain't got a thing to do how good you are? It's got everything to do with how good He is. My praise is not predicated on how good I've been this week. My praise has been predicated on how good God's been to me this week. What's holding your praise back? Has God been good to you this week? If He has, and you're not ashamed to throw both hands up and say, Lord, you've been good to me this week. I hadn't been so good this week, Lord, but you've been good. I haven't got it all right this week, Lord, but you've been right every day. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Jeffy's been good to you. He brought you out of the mire clay of sin, saved you, gave you a wonderful family, and poured His Spirit inside of you. That's what Jesus does for you. I'm not ashamed to throw up some hands and give Him praise. Somebody says, well, that's not necessary. No. I praised Him flat on my back when I couldn't do that. I've done it in the hospital. I did it when I had COVID. Hallelujah. I want you, Tamara, right now, in the name of Jesus, God is going to take that burden off of you. Twice, you come in here so burdened today, you can hardly lift your head. But I come to tell you, launch this morning. Launch on out with Jesus today. Though no one join you, no matter what they said or done to you, leave it all behind in the name of Jesus. Leave it all behind. Leave it all behind. Leave it all behind. Thank you, Lord. Go on with Jesus. Go on with Jesus. If I could stress just one thing to you, don't stop. I know you get tired and weary like this fisherman, but don't stop. Man, I've been so weary. I've come in here some Sunday mornings. I didn't know what I was going to do. I know y'all might say, well, you're the preacher. You don't know what you're going to do? Yes. How many of you know we ain't got our act together all the time? Y'all ain't with me 24-7, but Jesus is. We see each other on Sunday morning best. Can I get a witness in the house? Some of the mess we deal from Sunday to Sunday is tough. So I'm going to ask, is anybody in this room, what's holding your praise back? Give him your praise. What's holding your worship back? Give him your worship. Give him your worship. And if you have a need this morning, you need prayer, this altar's opened. And you can come. And we'll pray for you. We will pray for you. We will pray that God will heal Sister Ida this week. She's got some tests she's got to have done. Her back is in rough shape, but God's going to heal her back. Anybody else? You need prayer. She came. Anybody else? You know what? I believe that we can all say this morning, I could use a little prayer. Anybody say, I could sure use some of that prayer, preacher. Put me on the list. Anybody else? I want everybody in this congregation to stretch your hand towards Sister Ida right now. And I want you to pray the prayer of faith over her that God heal her body. She's standing against this wall, and there's a reason for that. Her balance is off. But I believe God's going to heal her. Father, in the name of Jesus, I pray healing over this woman of God right now. Lord, I speak wellness, wholeness. I speak that this back, Lord God, would be healed in the mighty name of Jesus, and that her walk would be steady. Oh, thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord, for what you've done and what you're doing right now. In the name of Jesus, be healed right now. Be healed right now. In the mighty name of Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Are you broken? Are you broken? I'm going to really help somebody now. God does wonderful work with broken things. I'm going to share a little bit with you. When I got saved, I was broken. How many know sometimes we got to get broken to get to Jesus? I was broken. And the Lord saved me. And even coming to church today, I said, Lord, I'm broken. But you know what he said? He said, that does not disqualify you from me blessing you. I said, Lord, I've got some issues. And you know what his answer was? I know it. How many of you know everybody has issues? How many of you know every family's got some issues? Can I get a witness in the house? If you got the perfect family, you might need to come up here and tell the rest of us. Can I get a witness? But they ain't perfect. But I love every one of them. How about you? I mean that. I mean that. I said this morning, I talked to Cynthia this morning, I said the greatest thing my kids can do for me on Father's Day is show up in church. And my grandkids, and I'm telling you, I am beside myself right now because God has been good to me. And I launched out many years ago, and I'm going to stay on course because this is the right way to go, ladies and gentlemen. Everybody love the Lord this morning. Everybody going to have a happy Father's Day this afternoon. One more survey. How many of you plan to eat something this afternoon? How many of you have said, I don't want to get you too thinking about it right now, but how many of you know that this afternoon I'm going to spend a little time with my family? Anybody else? I'm going to do that. And if it ain't but 5 minutes, that's all I need. I got to quit. I'm done. But Jesus loves you. Everybody love the Lord this morning? Are you ready to go eat? Be honest. Say, yeah. I love you. Happy Father's Day. Launch out. You know the drill for the giving. We've come up in the world now. We got a little box out there with looks pretty. Thank you for your giving.
Since